मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड अवर चैप्टर कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री, इन विच वट वी हैव लर्न दैट व्हेन टू लाइंस, व्हेन टू एक्सिस परपेंडिकुलर टू ईच अदर, परपेंडिकुलर मीन्स 90 डिग्री, व्हेन दीज टू लाइंस इंटरसेक्ट ईच अदर एट 90 डिग्री एंगल, देन द कार्टेशियन प्लेन विल फॉर्म एंड दीज टू लाइन इंटरसेक्ट दिस पॉइंट एंड दिस पॉइंट इज नोन एज ओरिजिन. So the intersecting point, intersection point of these two lines is known as origin, and this horizontal line is x-axis and this vertical line is y-axis. On x-axis, RHS is positive x-axis and the LHS represent the negative x-axis. On the y-axis, the points on the upward side will represent the positive y-axis and the downward side represent the negative of y-axis. Today we are going to learn more about how to plot the points on a graph paper. How we are going to plot the points on a graph paper? So for this, what we are going to do, we are just going to take the, I have written some examples here, we will take these examples. But before this, you just follow these three steps, first, second and third. If you will follow these three steps, then definitely you will able to plot the points very correctly. So the first point, I have taken 5, 3. On this 5, 3, I am going to apply all the three steps. The first step is identify the x and y values. So 5, 3, you just tell me the y, x point and y point. So x is 5 here and y is 3 here. So first step is completed here, that we have identified the x and y. X means first point, y means second point. And the second point is locate the value on x and y axis. What you have to do, just hide this y value. And x is equal to 5. Just see on the x axis and where is x? 5. So x is 5 here. Just plot this point. After that, the y is equal to 3. Y is equal to 3 means there is no role of the x-axis. You just go on y-axis and just check it out, where is 3. So y is 3 here. So you just plot this point. So second step is also completed. We have, first step is identify x and y separately. Second point is plot x and y separately. Now the third point, plot the point where the x and y meet. You have to plot the point, you just extend this y, x is 5, you just increase this one and extend this one and extend this y also, and definitely these two lines will intersect each other. You have to draw the perpendicular lines here. You can also draw the rough by the freehand also. So when these two lines intersect each other, this is your point 5, 3. This is your point 5, 3. The second point is -2, 3. So what is the value of x axis here? X is -3 and y is 2. X is -3, y is 2. So you just see where x is -3. Here x is -3. Y is 2. Here y is 2. Just extend these lines. When you will extend these two lines, this point will form and this point is known as -3, 2. The next point is 2, -4. So what is the value of x here? 2. What is the value of y here? -4. Second step is locate the values on x-axis and y-axis. So you just go on x-axis and the point is 2. Now the second is y is -4. Just go on y and y is -4. This is x. Y is -4 here. Just extend this perpendicular line and extend this perpendicular line. When these two will intersect, this point is known as 2, -4. So here we have plotted the point 2, -4. See, if I am plotting 2, so I can go this side also. But you have to move that side in which the second point is also there. So this is the point 2, -4. And the next is -1, -5. How we will plot the point? minus 1 comma minus 5 for plotting the point minus 1 comma minus 5. You just write x axis here minus 1 and the y is minus 5. I just have separated x point and y point. After that x is minus 1. You just see the x axis and where is minus 1? Here. X is minus 1. Then y is minus 5. You just see y and where is minus 5? This is plus 5. So minus 5 is here. And here I am going to extend this side. Because us side to extend karne ka koi logic hi nahi hai hamara. So I will extend this side, this number and then 5. So this point will come and this is minus 1 comma minus 5. When you will draw it on a proper graph paper, then these points can be drawn very accurately, very correctly. Fine, student. So this is all about these four points. Now second is 0 comma 2. See, I already told you if any point is 0, if any point is 0 in x and y, from x and y, if any point will become 0, then it will definitely not lie in the quadrant. These are known as the first quadrant, second quadrant and third quadrant and this is fourth quadrant. So 0 comma 2 will not lie in any quadrant. It will lie in on a axis. So 0 comma 2 will lie on 0 comma 2 means x is 0. Again the same steps. You just plot the separate the points 0 comma 2. So where is x 0? X and y both are 0 here. And second point, y is equal to 2. Y is equal to 2 here. So here we are not able to extend the line. When you will extend, this line will form. So y is equal to 2 will come on the axis only. So if any point will be 0 in x or from the y, then it will lie on the axis, not on the quadrants. The second point is 0 comma minus 3. X is 0, y is minus 3. X 0, no need to plot the point. Y minus 3, this is the point. So definitely it will not go in any quadrant. It will lie on the axis only. The next is 5 comma 0. So x is 5, y is 0. So x is 5 means here. Y 0 means no need to plot. This is the intersecting point. Already y is 0 here. So it means this point will be we are not going to extend the point. The last is minus 2 comma 4. Minus 2 comma 0, sorry. Minus 2 means x is minus 2. 0 means it will not go anywhere. It will not go in any quadrant. It will be remain here. Fine. Second is what you have to do. You should write like this. First A point. Then this point is B. Then this point is C. Then D and 0 comma 2. 0 comma 2 means this point. E. The next is 0 comma minus 3. 0 comma minus 3. This point is F. The next is 5 comma 0. This point is G. And the next point is H. This one is H. Minus 2 comma 0. So these are the naming of these points. So easily you can plot the point. You just have to follow the three steps. First step is identify x and y separately. First point is x point. Second point is y point. Second step, locate the values. X axis point, you have to plot x point on x axis and y point on y axis. After that, what you have to do? You just extend these lines and where these lines will intersect, this will be your required point, required coordinate on a Cartesian plane. And if any point will be 0, then definitely it will not lie on a quadrant, it will lie on the axis. So this is about how to plot the points and these questions are very important according to exam point of view also. And you have to plot these points on a graph paper. Then you will be able to understand more about it. Clear, student? So that's all for today. Thank you, students.